What's up, guys? My name is Zack, and today I am driving a 1992 Toyota pickup. Up front is a 2.4 liter inline four, and down below is a 5-speed manual transmission. Now, you are hearing me and not seeing me today because my GoPro decided that today, after almost 800 videos, it would finally give up and no longer record any video. So you are just gonna deal with audio, Zack, today as I drive over the worst road in Illinois. But I am super excited to be driving this Toyota pickup because these trucks are so simple. There's not a whole lot to them, but they're so great. I mean, I really truly think these are some of the best trucks to come out of the 20th century, bar none. So I'm always excited to share a vehicle like that with you today. But if you would like to share your vehicle with me, you can head on over to my website, zackpratel.com/submit. It's a quick and easy submission form, takes under a minute to fill out. I come out to you, and a link to that submission page is found in the description below. But let's get back to that 2.4 liter inline four under the hood, known as the 22RE. Now, this engine has been around in a couple of different forms for quite some time. And calling this engine reliable is a disservice to the term itself. These engines are so rock solid that it has a stronger willpower than the Black Knight from Monty Python's Holy Grail. This engine will outlive governments and factions worldwide, and that is why it's the Holy Grail. Now, there was also the 3-liter V6 of this era. Now, those had head gasket issues here and there. And overseas, you could actually get it with a forklift engine, which you are seeing now. So thank you, Andrew, for pulling out your forklift to show me the engine. Now, like I said, paired to it is a 5-speed manual. It's incredibly friendly to shift. It's incredibly fun to shift. Clutch is super light. Shifter is super notchy. And it's just overall an incredibly fun experience. Last but not least, this particular Toyota pickup is rear-wheel drive. However, you could have found them with four-wheel drive, but this just isn't that. So how's it feel to drive a Toyota pickup? Like I said with the shifting, it's fun, it's light, it's nimble, it's easy. When you close your eyes as a kid and you take your Sunny D bottle and pretend to be shifting your own gears, even though you're barely through middle school, that's exactly what this feels like. It feels like everything you dream a manual vehicle to feel like, and it does it so perfectly and so effortlessly. That is one of the many joys of Toyota vehicles. With that stuff out of the way, let's talk about this bare bones interior. Well, in front of me, I have three cages: coolant temperature, speed, and fuel. That's all you need to know. On the steering wheel, don't get any buttons. Don't need them. Off to left, I have a climate control vent and some gauge dimmer switches. And on the door, latch, get in and out, and crank for the window. Moving into the center, hazard switch, climate control vents, again, very fancy, and a cup holder. Does it pass the big friggin' model test? No! Of course not! Why would it? And then we have our climate controls. This was an AC truck, but the belt snapped, so it's not an AC truck anymore. However, that was the only option that was spec'd out here on this particular Toyota pickup was AC, and I don't even get to friggin' enjoy it. But then we have an aftermarket radio, because every radio from the 90s was garbage. Little pull-out ashtray, some 12-volt outlets and cubbies. Floor-mounted shifter, of course, this is not the stock shift knob, but I really enjoy the throw and feeling of it. And then we gotta talk about the bench seat. Comfy, cushy, weathered, or as I like to say, seasoned, but comfortable nevertheless. And honestly, I just got out of a 2024 Chevy Trax, and it's more comfortable than that. So hats off to you, Toyota. Now, we don't have any back seats, but we do have a bed. Again, the simplicity continues on back there. I don't get any crazy tie downs. I don't get any outlets. I don't get any LED lights or power generators. It's just a bed. That's it. And that's all you need. While we're outside though, let's talk about the exterior. I don't think it's a particularly super handsome automobile, but it is here for a job. It's here to do the work. And you could see that it has not lived an easy life, but that's okay. It wasn't meant to. This wasn't meant to be saved and put in a museum. No, no, no. This was meant to do the labor, and it most certainly has and most certainly will continue to do. However, with that in mind, let's get on to my final thoughts. What do I think driving a 1992 Toyota pickup? First of all, this isn't actually my first time I've driven a 1992 Toyota pickup. I drove a 92 Toyota pickup that was outfitted to be the Pizza Planet truck from Toy Story. So that was a very different video, but I'll link that one at the end if you're curious. Here's the thing. When a job requires a hammer, you go into your toolbox and you get a fucking hammer. This isn't a duct tape truck. This isn't WD-40. This won't band-aid your issues. It fixes them. It's there when you need it. And it doesn't have a single ounce extra beyond that. Honestly, the air conditioning is just to prevent heat stroke of the driver. That's kind of it. And there's something so beautifully simple about it. This truck is a saltine cracker. I might not seek it out in my day-to-day when I'm looking for some flavorful excitement, but when I'm sick, when I'm feeling under the weather, when my stomach's bothering me, there's nothing better than a saltine cracker. Oh, the crunch, the salt. The friendliness. And if you do want to dress it up, sure, put a little bit of peanut butter on top, put a little bit of cheese on top. You want to dress up the Toyota pickup? Throw a little lift kit, some wheels on it. You don't have to get crazy with it. It's so good as it is. And that's what makes this truck so special. That's why I wanted to drive this truck. You just don't really get simplicity like this anymore. And whether this thing is dropped out of a helicopter, dumped in a river, or parked out by the train tracks, it's gonna start, and it's gonna run, and it's gonna work. Every day, you'll be hard-pressed to find a truck that is more reliable than this.
Something interesting I just wanted to point out, these were built in the U.S. at the NUMMI plant as well as in Japan. So if it is from the NUMMI plant here in the U.S., the VIN starts with a 4. If it was built over in Japan, it'll start with a J. So kind of interesting that they are built in two locations. This is an American-built one.
I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Huge thank you to the owner, Andrew, for letting me take out his Toyota pickup. Andrew's been awesome. We filmed a bunch of his vehicles in the past. Andrew's been awesome to work with. Good friend of mine, and I look forward to filming more of his cars in the future. But I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I'm sorry you can't see my face. I promise in the next video, I'll be back. But for now, enjoy this selfie of me in front of the 1992 Toyota pickup. Take care, guys.